Hello guys, I am Sheetal and you are welcome back to your own Target Study YouTube channel. If I ask you one question, that what do you want to be? Most of you will answer that I want to be an engineer or a doctor or a CA. There are hundreds of other career options, but these are prevalent and talked about in general conversation, so these are the most obvious choices. Same is the case with engineering aspirants. If I ask an engineering aspirant about his or her choice of trade, then his or her obvious answer will be computer science or information technology. Reason is same, these two are the most talked about engineering trades and they should be, as these trades have changed the outlook of the society. But other engineering trades are equally good and rewarding as a career option. Now let me come on the main point. Even you opt for engineering trade like civil engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering or electronics and telecommunication engineering, you have good opportunities in both private as well as public sector. And today in this video, I'm going to talk about an exam that can enable you get top level post in various central government department. Some of you might have guessed the exam I'm talking about. Yes, my dear friends, I'm obviously talking about one and only Union Public Service Commission Engineering Services exam. In this video, I will try to answer your obvious questions about Engineering Services exam. Like what is UPSC Engineering Services exam? What are the eligibility conditions to take Engineering Services exam? What is the syllabus of Engineering Services exam? What is the pattern of Engineering Services exam? How to apply for it? And what is the registration fee for Engineering Services exam? If you are interested to know the answers of these questions, then keep watching this video till the very end. Now the very first question for those who don't know what exactly Engineering Services exam is. Indian Engineering Services exam, acronym as IES exam and also known as Engineering Services exam, is conducted by Union Public Service Commission of India for the recruitment of engineers to the four categories of engineering services, namely civil engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering and electronics and telecommunication engineering. For filling up various posts in the government organizations and any other organization that require the services of these four categories of engineers in their organizations. Like civil engineering candidates will be recruited in AEE and PNT Building Work Services, AEE in Border Road Engineering Services, Central Engineering Service, Central Engineering Service of Roads, Central Water Engineering Service, Indian Railway Services of Engineers, Indian Defence Service of Engineers, Indian Railway Store Service and Indian Ordnance Factory Services. Mechanical Engineering candidates will be recruited in Assistant Executive Engineering Geological Survey of India, Assistant Naval Store Officer in Indian Navy, Assistant Executive Engineering in Corps of EME and Ministry of Defence, Central Mechanical and Electrical Engineering Service, Central Water Engineering Service, Central Power Engineering Service, Central Engineering Service, Roads, Indian Railway Service of Mechanical Engineers, Indian Railway Store Service, Indian Defence Service of Engineers, Indian Ordnance Factory Services, Indian Inspection Service, Indian Supply Service, Mechanical Posts, and Indian Naval Armament Service. And Electrical Engineering candidates will be recruited in Assistant Naval Store Officer Grade 1 in Indian Navy, Assistant Executive Engineer in Corps of EME, Ministry of Defence, Central Mechanical and Electrical Engineering Service, Electrical Post, Central Power Engineering Service, Electrical Post, Indian Railway Services of Electrical Engineers, Indian Railway Store Services, Indian Defence Service of Engineers, Electrical Post, Indian Ordnance Factory Services, Indian Supply Service, Electrical Post, and Indian Naval Armament Service. Whereas Electronics and Communication Engineering will be recruited in Assistant Naval Store Officer Grade 1 in Indian Navy, Assistant Executive Engineer in Corps of EME, Ministry of Defence, Central Power Engineering Services, ENT Posts, Engineer GCS Group A in WPC, MO, MO Communication in IT, Indian Railway Service of Signal Engineers, Indian Railway Store Service, Indian Telecom Service, Indian Inspection Service, ENT Post, Indian Supply Service, ENT Post, Indian Ordnance Factory Services and Indian Naval Armament Service. Now you would like to know what is the eligibility to take Combined Engineering Services exam. Candidates wishing to appear in the Engineering Service exam should ensure that they fulfill all the eligibility conditions for admission to the examination. There are many eligibility terms set up for the candidates. Like the aspiring candidates must possess a bachelor's degree in engineering or technology or equivalent. The candidates who are yet to appear in the final exam of BE or BTech may also be allowed to appear in the exam provisionally. As far as age limits are concerned, the aspiring candidate must have attained the age of 21 years and must not have attained the age of 30 years on the 1st August of the year in which the exam is being held. The upper age limit is relaxed for the candidates who belong to reserved categories. Like for SC, ST, it is 5 years, for OBC, 3 years. Candidates who had ordinarily been domiciled in the state of Jammu and Kashmir during the period from 1st January 1980 to 31st day of December 1989, 5 years. Defence Services personnel disabled, 3 years. Ex-servicemen including commissioned officers and ECOs, SSCOs, 5 years, and PWD candidates, 10 years. Besides, the candidate must be either a citizen of India, or a subject of Nepal, or a subject of Bhutan, or a Tibetan refugee who came over to India before 1st January 1962 with the intention of permanently settling in India, person of Indian origin who has migrated from Pakistan, Burma, Sri Lanka, or East Africa. If you find yourself eligible to take engineering services exam, then you must definitely would like to know the pattern of engineering services exam. The engineering services exam will consist of 3 stages. Stage 1, that is preliminary examination, stage 2, the mains examination, and stage 3, personality test. Those candidates who will score the qualifying marks in the first stage will get admission to the mains exam. The marks obtained in preliminary test will be counted in the final merit list. There are 2 papers in the preliminary exam, that is, paper 1 and paper 2. Paper 1 will be an offline objective test of general studies and engineering aptitude test consisting of 200 marks to be completed in 2 hours. Paper 2 will be an offline objective test of engineering discipline consisting of 300 marks to be completed in 3 hours. Both papers will be in English only and 1/3 mark will be deducted for each wrong answer. The candidates who qualify the stage 1 will be allowed to appear in the stage 2. This stage 2 comprises of 2 papers, that is paper 1 and paper 2. Both papers will be offline conventional type of engineering discipline consisting of 300 marks to be completed in 3 hours each. The candidates must note that there will be a deduction of 5% marks from the total marks scored by the aspirant if their handwriting is not legible. Those candidates who are shortlisted in the written examination are required to appear for an interview which carries maximum marks of 200. Now you would like to know about the syllabus of Engineering Services exam. Paper 1 of the preliminary exam of Indian Engineering Services, that is General Studies and Engineering Aptitude, will consist of questions from current issues of national and international importance relating to social, economic and industrial development, engineering aptitude covering logical reasoning and analytical ability, engineering mathematics and numerical analysis, general principles of design, drawing, importance of safety, standards and quality practice in production, construction, maintenance and services, basics of energy environment, conservation environmental pollution and degradation, climate change, environmental impact assessment, basics of project management, basics of material science and engineering, information and communication technologies, ICT, based on tools and their application in engineering such as networking, e-governance in technology-based education, and ethics and values in engineering profession. Whereas, paper 2 of preliminary examination and paper 1 and 2 of mains examination contain the content related to chosen engineering discipline of the level of BE or BTech. For detailed syllabus of these papers, you can visit our website targetstudy.com's UPSC exams section. Now you would like to know how to apply for engineering service exam. you can apply for UPSC Engineering Services exam by following certain steps. First of all, you have to visit the official exam portal of the UPSC, that is www.upsconline.nic.in. There, you will find out link for application form named as Engineering Services Exam or Indian Engineering Services Exam. Click on it. After clicking, you will be directed to the application form of examination. There, you have to register yourself. You have to enter your basic details like candidate name, parents or guardian names, date of birth, postal address, valid and active mobile number and email address, qualification background, etc. Fill out all the details carefully and correctly. Then you have to upload the scanned copies of your passport size photograph and running hand signature. Once you upload the photograph and signature, click on the submit button. Before submission, cross-check all the details you entered. After that, you have to pay for the examination. You can pay by two modes, online and offline mode. In online or electronic mode, you can pay your application fee by using Visa, Master, RuPay credit, debit card, net banking facility of State Bank of India. In offline mode, when you choose the pay by cash mode, system will be generated to pay in slip called Chalan. This Chalan is payable at any branch of the SBI across the country. Now the most obvious question, what is the registration fee for Combined Engineering Services exam? The registration fee for this exam is Rs. 200 for general and OBC category candidates, and there is no fee for SC or ST category candidates. So guys, if you have done your engineering degree with any of the above four trade, then taking and clearing this exam can really provide wings to your career in the public sector. That's all from this video guys. I hope you find this video informative. If you like this video, give a thumbs up. For more such videos, subscribe Target Study YouTube channel. And to get regular notification, hit the bell icon. Thank you for watching.